Please stand for the guest one. Please stand for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What is up, Conf? Today is Friday the 13th, 2013. I'm George Visconti.
And I'm Zach Thornton. And it's once again time for KTV Live Intergalactic.
Well, Zach, we know we have benchmarks today. And Friday the 13th isn't too good, but really, I'm lucky. Because in Italy, it is lucky.
I know. I'm lucky, too.
Yeah, really? So yeah. It's looking pretty good today.
Yeah, so let's get into the news.
Yep. Today's KTV holiday is ice cream day. During a hot summer day, what is the one thing you want? It is ice cream. According to HolidayLights.com, ice cream is nutritious, a little heavy on the sugar and calories. Ice cream is otherwise good for you. Its base ingredient is milk, which is loaded with healthy vitamins and minerals. According to www.activebeat.com, the most popular ice cream flavor is vanilla.
Come School has many clubs and activities for the students to participate in. One club is Math Club. Math Club is a club where you can use your mind and skills and participate in math problems with your pals. Ms. Pachano runs Math Club. She stated that students should join this club because it's really fun and a great way to exercise your brain with your friends. Math Club takes place in room 8 and starts at 2:45. Math Club's next meeting is December 18th. Other meeting dates will soon be announced.
According to CNN.com, the Charities Aid Foundation in London crowned the United States the world's most generous nation, up from fifth place last year.
Christmas is coming up soon, so Greg has an interview with someone special. So, I mean, I love Christmas, you know, it's a really great holiday. It's in like 2 weeks, so let's pass it to Greg.
So Christmas is coming up in like 2 weeks, so I decided to interview Santa Claus because he is very important to the Christmas holiday.
What is your history?
I started at St. Nicholas, a well-known gift-giving saint. After a while, each country or region developed their own gift-giver. The Santa that we know began in 1823. He depicted me as a plump, jolly old fellow with a white beard and smoking a long pipe.
How do you travel on Christmas to deliver presents to children around the world?
Lots of ways. I have a sleigh drawn by a team of reindeer, but I also have a team of dogs, a car, an airplane, a snowmobile, and a helicopter. I use whatever means of transportation is best suited to the conditions and the purpose of my journey.
How do you have time to deliver all the presents?
I take advantage of the differences between time zones. When children in Finland are awake, children in Japan are asleep, and vice versa. There is also some magic involved. Sometimes I may delegate the elves to deliver presents. The most important thing is that the gifts get there on time.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
According to GrammarManComic.com, Santa has a calculated 31 hours to deliver gifts due to the different time zones and rotation of the Earth.
So, Joe, I was really busy last night, and I didn't really get to look at any sports, so can you fill me in?
Well, there wasn't that many games you missed, but Okay. Yesterday in football, the Chargers bested the Broncos with a score of 27-20.
That's pretty shocking.
I mean, that helps me in fantasy. I have Danny Woodhead.
That's really good.
And in basketball, the Brooklyn Nets beat the Los Angeles Clippers by a score of 102-98. I thought the Clippers were going to win that game, personally.
Really?
But
wow.
Also, the Portland Trail Blazers beat the Houston Rockets 111-104.
Yeah, a little later in the sports day, but it was still solid.
Yeah. All right, let's go back to this.
See ya.
Recently, sixth grader Eddie Duffy posted on Comf Infinity blog about the two top superheroes. Which two superheroes did he use in his blog? Was it A, Thor and Superman? Possibly B, Superman and Iron Man, or an Iron Man, or possibly D, Superman and Batman. The first comic book hero was Superman in 1938, but the first official superhero was the Shadow in 1931. And the answer is A, Thor and Superman. Thor is from Marvel, while Superman is from DC Comics. Thor's greatest ability is his godlike invulnerability and his unique hammer, while Superman's special powers are heat vision, freeze vision, X-ray vision, and even more. According to Eddie D's blog, Superman would defeat Thor in a fight, 1v1. Eddie D is looking for more superhero ideas. If you have any, please comment below in his post on kidblog.com/kumpf.
A preview of the annual meteor shower occurred yesterday over Tucson, Arizona. According to CNN, Gemini contains the name of the constellation Gemini, which is the direction the meteors came from.
Okay, so George, we have a break in the show, right?
Yes, with Brenner and Lee over there. So let's pass it over to them.
All right, Brenner, so we have a pretty crazy schedule today.
We do. So it is 8-9, then you go to 1-2, then you go to 5-6-7, then you go to 3-4. So, I mean, it's pretty cool.
Yep, so let's get back to the news.
Really important because, you know, you don't want to go to the wrong classes.
That's never good. You just want to be late either.
Yeah, you just can't do it.
Yeah, so hopefully you were listening to that. Let's get back to the news.
Yep. CNN.com stated that the top U.S. spot is Grand Rapids and Lake Michigan's Gold Coast. It's such an overlooked part of the Midwest, says a woman, and so deserving of attention by travelers who love art, beer, and food, and the beach.
Education should be very important because it will shape our futures.
Hello, everybody. This is George Visconti, and I will be talking about some national news. Well, first, assessments has American 15-year-olds ranked 14th in reading, 17th in science, and 25th in math, among other developed nations. However, countries like Finland and South Korea always rank near top. We recently looked at what they did to be so successful.
So, according to CNN.com, South Korea is the pressure cooker model, which is when kids are working all day and night, and they are under a lot of pressure to do well on tests. Finland, however, is the option in many ways. They are an utopia model. They really focus on quality over quantity, and the kids on average do less homework than we do, but achieve very high on world tests.
I would rather be a part of a utopia model because I don't do well on tests when I'm pressured, and I also would rather do critical thinking than work all day and night.
According to DoSomething.org, our nation's education assessment is largely derived from graduation rate. Every year, only 69% of American high school's seniors earn their diploma.
So, Jeff, you know, I can't believe the snow still is out there.
Yeah, I know.
But I'm really not informed on, like, what's going on temperature-wise.
We're
going
to get more snow. I'm just going to say it right now.
Wow.
Let's get into the weather. On today, it'll be a high of 25 with the clouds out. Saturday, it'll be a high of 27, but we're going to get snow.
That's good.
We're going to get pounded, I'm telling you.
Wow, I'm excited.
Sunday, it's going to be a high of 36 degrees, and we're going to get more snow.
That's always good.
And Monday, 27, to start off the week with sun hiding behind the clouds.
That's good. I mean, we have not seen the sun in a while, so
I'm very excited for that. I'm looking forward to it.
Yep. See you, Jeff.
Today's KTV birthday is Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift is a country singer born in Pennsylvania. According to FamousBirthdays.com, before stardom, Taylor performed at musical theater shows at age 9. By the age of 23, she won 7 Grammy Awards, including Best Album for Fearless. Taylor Swift has wrote over 200 songs, starting when she was 12 years old. Okay, George, we now have an announcement with Danielle, so let's see what she's got to say.
So Monday, the show is going to be great, filled with a quiz on the 8th grade history project, and a video on cyberbullying, so.
Thanks, Danielle, that was really important.
Yes, I know, Monday show is gonna be a good start off the week.
Yeah, also, today's Ms. Colby's speech day, so if that applies to you, you got
please
speech.
Please do that. So for even more KTV news, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. For Zachary Thornton and the rest of the KTV news team, I'm George Visconti. Have a splendid day.